Hi guys, Alex from QuickSolar. So I get the question a lot, can I do ballasted systems with QuickSolar? And the answer is an emphatic yes, you can. I'm going to go over a neat little trick here for doing ballasted systems quickly and easily. I'm set up in the design tool with a flat roof. You'll notice I'm in top view, which can be changed by clicking the slider here in the upper right. Now I'm using the Unirack RM10 ballasted system in this example. I have no affiliation with the Unirack company. Just a totally random product that I'm picking for this tutorial. And with the RM10, I'm using the Canadian Solar 260s because I know they're compatible. Unirack also wants me to lay out my modules in landscape mode, so the first thing I'm going to do is switch over to landscape from portrait here. Now I'm going to create my first row of modules, and the easiest way to do that is to use the rectangle tool to create one row from corner to corner and get it in place here. So I need to know now what the distance between rows of modules needs to be, and to find that I need to look at the ballast system spec sheet or installation details. Usually you'll find something that looks somewhat like this, which is from the Unirack RM10 details guide. What I'm essentially looking for is the end-to-end distance between modules, or the distance between the back edge of one module to the front edge of another. Again, this is just an example. Every ballasted product out there will have its own way of showing this measurement, but it's an important measurement to have. In this case, it's going to be 17 and 7/16 inches, or about 17.5 inches. I like to round up a little bit to give myself some wiggle room. Back in the design tool, I'm going to use my distance tool to measure my 17 and a half inch line. So I go to the More icon, I select Distance tool. Make sure I have inches set as my units. I'm going to draw my line to get it at 17.5 inches. It's important to note that I'm using the ground distance here, since this is a flat measurement taken on the ground as opposed to one taken on a sloped roof. So now I'll X out of the design tool, and that red line will stay with me as I move away. I'm going to select this row of modules by using the select icon, dragging a box from corner to corner, then copy my selection by clicking the copy icon. If you're a PC user, you can also use Control C on your keyboard to copy a selection of modules as well. Now I'm going to take my new row of panels and simply put it behind the red distance line I've created, and I've got my second row now in place. Now, to continue to grow my solar design, the trick I like to use is to use these first two rows as sort of a template for my design as placeholders, and I'll show you what I mean. I'm going to copy these two rows by selecting them and clicking the copy icon, and I'm going to stick these on the side of my array as my placeholders for now and delete them later. Now I can copy again, put your new rows in place, knowing that these are now at the proper inner row spacing at about 17 and a half inches, and I can continue doing this until my roof is fully covered. Just keep on adding on to your template and adding on to your rows. And once your roof gets to a point to where it's covered, you can select your placeholder rows and click the delete icon to delete them. You can also begin adjusting the layout as needed by taking off modules where there are obstructions, provided that your ballasted system manufacturer allows for it and following all their design protocols that they may dictate. Hopefully this helps. Thanks for watching.